Assalamu alaikum. Today we will talk about section 7.3, which is about trigonometric substitution. In this section, we will treat special class of functions, integral of root a square minus x square, integral root a square plus x square, and integral root x square minus a square. Each one has a corresponding substitution. For example, the first one, which is root a square minus x square, we need to use the substitution x equal a sine theta, where theta between minus pi over 2 up to pi over 2 closed. Why do we use this substitution and why do we choose this interval? In fact, the reason behind this is to break out this root. To clarify the idea,
let us see this example.
Let us take x equal a sine theta, where theta between minus pi over 2 closed up to pi over 2 closed. If we do it this way, then this integral will be root a square minus x square. Read it from here. It is a square sine square theta. And what is the x? Let us find it. It is a cosine theta d theta. We just differentiate here. So I will say a cosine theta d theta. Now, let us take a square common factor under the root to get 1 minus sine square theta. And this is a cosine theta d theta. If you take a square outside, it will be absolute value a, but we take a to be positive, so we are ending with a only. And what is 1 minus sine square? By this identity, it is cosine square theta. And let us simplify here. This will be a absolute value of cosine theta. And what is absolute value of cosine theta? Look at this interval. We choose it to be between minus pi over 2 up to pi over 2. Because from minus pi over 2 up to pi over 2, we are in the first quadrant or the fourth quadrant, and the cosine there is positive. So we will end up with a cosine theta. Now, do not forget to copy paste the following. A cosine theta d theta, all the way. So we end up with an integral of a square cosine square theta d theta. So this substitution enables us to change this integral of root type into a trigonometric integral, which is already done in the previous section, section 7.2. All right, do you see the idea behind this substitution? There is one thing. The other question is this. Why did we choose this specific interval? Let us recall the graph of sine x. It is something like this. I am drawing here one period from minus pi up to pi, for example. Look here. From minus pi over 2 up to pi over 2, this is the restricted domain to make the function sine x to be 1 to 1. At the beginning, this is not 1 to 1. You can apply the horizontal line test. But once we take it from minus pi over 2 up to pi over 2, we get a 1 to 1 function. And hence, we can define the inverse. So this is the main reason for having this interval, to make it 1 to 1. And hence to define the inverse. You will see this once we are in the examples. In summary, if you have root a square minus x square, you need to use the substitution x equal a sine theta in this interval. If you have root a square plus x square, you need to use x equal a tan theta in this interval. And also, if you have root x square minus a square, you need to use x equal a secant theta on this interval or in this interval. Example number one, it says evaluate this integral root 9 minus x square dx over x square. First, we need to use the sine substitution. Why? Look here, we have a square minus x square. So the suitable substitution is a sine theta. What is my a? You can take it to be root 9. So x equal 3 sine theta, where theta between minus pi over 2 closed up to pi over 2 closed. Now what is my dx? It will be 3 cosine theta d theta. Now let us organize our work by working out the root outside. It will be 9 minus, what is x square? Read it from here. It is 9 sine square theta. This is the same idea. You take 9 outside the root. It will be 3. And you are left with 1 minus sine square theta. And this is equal 3 root cosine square theta. But this is equal 3 absolute value of cosine theta. And this is equal 3 cosine theta. Why? Because I already explained this. Let us repeat. From minus pi over 2 up to pi over 2, we are in quadrant number 1 and 4, so the cosine there is positive. Now, let us plug back everything in the integral. We have root 9 minus x square. It is equal to 3 cosine theta. See it over here. So I will say 3 cosine theta. Now, plug dx. Clearly, it is 3 cosine theta d theta. Now let us divide by x square. Read it from here. It is 9 sine square theta. Now let us simplify. 3 with 3 and 9. Everything is gone. Cosine times cosine is cosine square over sine square. That is cotan square theta. Now let us recall how to integrate cotan square. You need to use this identity, which is cosecant square theta minus 1. Remember, this is not in the table, but if you write it this way, now everything here is in the table. What is the integral of cosecant square? It is similar to secant square. So the answer here will be minus cotan theta. Just double check. What is the derivative of cotan is minus cosecant square. So this is the reason for having this minus. Minus integral of 1 is theta, because we are in the theta world, plus constancy. Now the integral is in terms of x, but we get something in terms of theta. Let us put everything back in terms of x only by drawing the following triangle. Recall, x equal to 3 sine theta is equivalent to sine theta is equal x over 3. Clearly, this is my x and this is my 3. Recall this, sine theta is opposite over hypotenuse. المقابل على الوتر in Arabic. And this guy will be by the Pythagorean law, 9 minus x square. I mean this square minus this one square. So if we do it this way, let us find cotan from the triangle. Let us find tan first. What is tan? It is opposite over adjacent. But I need cotan, so it will be the other way around. Root over x. Minus theta. What is my theta? This is very important. Since we are in the restricted domain, then my theta is equal. You can take sine inverse for both sides to get sine inverse x over 3. And this only if you have this interval. Otherwise, you are not allowed to do this. So in fact, our real substitution is theta equals sine inverse of x over 3. But we write it this way to make the calculation simpler. Now let us plug back our theta, which is sine inverse of x over 3. And we end up with adding a constancy. All right. And it is good for you to verify your answer. Here I have some quick notes. If your work is correct, then you will be able to break out the root. Note number 2. If your work is correct, then this root should appear in the triangle over here. And this is a last note. If you put 3 sine, then the output will be 3 cosine. Why? Just do it this way and you will understand later on. Question 2a. He said find the integral of root a square minus x square dx where a greater than 0. We already did this at the beginning. We said x equals a sine theta where theta is in this interval. And dx is a cosine theta, d theta. Now let us work out the root. It is root a square minus x square, which is a square minus my x square. You can find it from here by taking power 2 for both sides. And hence, you can take a square outside the radical to get a only. Remember, a is positive. And we are ending with 1 minus sine square theta. And we said this will be a root cosine square. What is that? It is absolute value of cosine theta, but I don't need to put absolute value because I already said this 2 times. Let us repeat quickly. From minus pi over 2 to pi over 2, the cosine function is positive there. So once we input a sine, we end up with a cosine. Now let us plug back everything in the integral. This root becomes a cosine theta, as we did before, and our dx is a cosine theta, and here we have d theta. So we are getting integral of a square times cosine square theta. How to integrate this? We already did this in the previous section. We said you need to use this identity, which is 1 over 2, 1 plus cosine 2 theta, d theta. Now, let us integrate to get a square over 2. I will take it outside the integral. Integrate 1 to get theta plus, what is the integral of cosine 2 theta? We said this many times. This is sine 2 theta. Then you need to divide by 2. This 2 comes from the substitution. Imagine you have w equal to theta, dw equal to d theta. Then you will have this 2 down here, plus constancy. Now, before we create our triangle, let us simplify this little bit. Here we get a square over 2 theta plus 1 over 2. What is sine 2 theta? Yes, it is 2 sine theta cosine theta plus constancy. Now let us create the triangle. This is our theta. Look here at the substitution. Sine theta is equal x over a. Let me write it. So this will be my x and this will be my a. Opposite over hypotenuse. So this guy will be a square minus x square. Now let us plug back everything here to get a square over 2. And what is theta? As we said last time, it is sine inverse of x over a. And this is allowed only if you are in this specific interval. 2 will cancel this 2 plus. What is sine? Already we wrote it here. It is x over a. What is cosine? Clearly it is this root over a. I repeat, it is adjacent over hypotenuse. Plus consistency. Alright, now you can simplify this a little bit if you wish. Now let us repeat our notes. If our work is correct, then we will break out with the root. If you input a sine, you will get a cosine. If your work is correct, then you should get the radical in the triangle over here. Now let us use this result to solve part B, which is a familiar one. Part B, it says find the integral from 0 to a root a square minus x square dx where a is positive. As I said, this is a familiar question to us. We said this in section 5.2. To evaluate this integral, we can graph y equal root a square minus x square, which is a circle. But since we have a root, we need the upper part. Here we have from 0 to a. That means we are going from here to here. So we will end up with an area of a quarter of a circle. Right? So this integral directly will be 1 over 4 by r square. What is my r? It is a here. And that is a square. All right? Now let us verify our result by using part A. Remember, in part A, we get the integral of root A square minus X square equal to this term here. If you need to evaluate the integral from 0 to A, simply just evaluate here from 0 to A. Let us do this. If you plug A, you will get sine inverse A over A. That is sine inverse of 1. It is pi over 2. You need to know this. And this is A square over 2. Plug A here, you get A square minus A square. That is 0. Now let us plug 0. Sine inverse of 0 is 0. Now plug 0 here, you will get 0. Now simplify this. Isn't it by a square over 4, which is the same result over here? So do you see the beauty of trick substitution? Now it is good for us to recall the following from the prepare. This is theta, this is the opposite, O, this is the hypotenuse, H, and this is adjacent. In Arabic, المقابل المجاور الوتر. So what is sine theta? It is opposite over hypotenuse. Look here, opposite over hypotenuse, المقابل على الوتر. Cosine theta, it is a adjacent over hypotenuse, المجاور على الوتر. Tan theta, it is o over a, that is opposite over adjacent, المقابل على المجاور. If you know these three, you can find cosecant, secant, cotan, etc. All right, question number 3. It says integrate 1 over x square root x square plus 4. See here, the root is appearing in the denominator. We don't care whether it is upstairs or downstairs. Once you have root x square plus a square, then the suitable substitution will be x equal a tan theta, where theta between minus pi over 2 to pi over 2. What is the suitable substitution? It will be x equal 2 tan theta. Why did I choose tan? Because you have addition between them. Why did I put 2? Because the root of 4 is 2. And this is our interval over here. Now let us find dx and the root. Dx will be 2 secant square theta d theta. Alright, let us work out with the root. It will be x square. It is 4 tan square. You just take power 2 for both sides. Plus 4. Same steps as we did before. Take 4 outside to get 2. Then you are left with 1 plus tan square theta. What is this? This secant square under the root. If you simplify it, you will get 2 absolute value of secant. But I don't need absolute value. I will say secant directly. Why? Let us repeat this. From minus pi over 2 up to pi over 2, the cosine is positive. And similarly, the secant will be positive. Let us plug back everything in the integral to get dx equal to secant square theta d theta divided by x square. Read it from here. That is 4 tan square. What is the root? We work it outside, see it here and here. We get 2 secant theta. Now let us simplify. 2 with 2 will be gone. 1 secant from here will cancel this secant. So we end up with 1 over 4 integral of secant theta over tan square theta. Now think how to evaluate this integral. This is not discussed in the previous strategies. I mean, here the power of tan is even. We do not have a strategy for that. The power of secant is odd. We do not have a strategy for this. So how can we do this? Simply, you can change to sine and cosine. So you will get 1 over cosine theta. divided by sine square over cosine square. Right? Because sine square is sine square over cosine square. Now let us simplify this by multiplying by cosine square up and down. Here I will get cosine theta because I multiply by cosine square. And if you do it here, you will kill this cosine square. Then you are left with sine square theta d theta. Now this integral is very interesting. We will do it using two methods. The first method is to separate like this. Cosine theta over sine times 1 over sine theta d theta. I didn't do anything. Look here. Cosine times 1 is cosine. Sine times sine is sine square. But if you write it this way, then we are done. Look here. We get cotan theta cosecant theta d theta. This is simply minus cosecant theta plus constancy. If you didn't believe me, if you differentiate cosecant, you will get minus cotan cosecant. And this is the reason for having this minus. Now let us create our rectangle and game is over. Recall, our substitution is x equal to tan theta, or in other words, tan theta is equal x over 2. This is our theta, this is x, and this is 2. It is opposite over adjacent, and this guy clearly will be x squared plus 4. All right, maybe we forget 1 over 4 over here. So the final answer will be minus 1 over 4 cosecant. What is cosecant? Or let us simplify the question. What is sine? Isn't it x over the root? So the cosecant will be the other way around. It will be the root over x. And do not forget to add a constant c. Now I will ask you a question. And if you see the recording, please think for 10 seconds. This integral can be done using another method. What is that? 10 seconds only. Thank you very much, Ibrahim. We need to take u equal to sine because the derivative is upstairs. Let us see it here. I did it for you. This is the integral. If you take u equal to sine, then du will be cosine theta d theta. Cosine theta d theta will be gone with the du. Sine square will be u square. Remember, your u is sine theta. Now, how to integrate this? Simply, you write it u to the power minus 2. You add 1 into the exponent and you divide by the new exponent. Simplify, you will get 1 over sine, or in other words, that is cosecant. And we get the same result. All right. Here I have a quick note. See here. We input 2 tan theta and we get 2 secant theta. From where we get this? Because this is coming from the identity 1 plus tan square equal secant square. There is one thing. If your work is correct, then you will break the root. Now, do you see this root in the question? It is appearing in the triangle. So that means you are going correctly. Question number 4. He said, find the integral 1 over root x square minus a square dx, where a is positive. Which substitution should be used? Clearly, we will use x equal a secant theta because we have root x square minus a square. So, as I said, x equal a secant theta, where theta between 0 up to pi over 2, or theta between pi up to 3 pi over 2. You can see it over here. Let us find dx. Clearly, this will be a secant theta tan theta. Now, let us work out the root. It should be x square. Read it from here. If you put power 2 for both sides, you will get a square secant square theta minus a square. And note something, if your work is correct, you should get a square here. That means you have the same number, so you can take it outside the root. If you do not have this, then you made a mistake. So if you take a square outside, you will get a, because a is positive, no need for absolute value. So we end up with secant square theta minus 1. What is this? This is a tan square. Under the root, it will be tan. It should be absolute value. But I don't need absolute value. Y from 0 to pi over 2, this is the first quadrant, so the tan is positive there. Or between pi up to 3 pi over 2, this is the third quadrant, so the tan is already positive there. Now let us plug back everything. Our dx is a secant tan divided by the root, which is already calculated here, which is a tan theta. So you can cancel this a with a, since a is positive. We can do this. Tan with tan will be gone. So we are left with secant. Now, what is the integral of secant? Already we did it in the previous section. So I will write this. It is directly ln secant theta plus tan theta plus constancy. All right. Now let us create our triangle. This is theta. Remember, x equal a secant theta is equivalent to saying secant theta equal x over a. Just to simplify your life, secant theta equal x over a, it is equivalent to cosine theta equal a over x. So this will be my a and this will be by x المجاور على الوتر. And this guy clearly it will be x square minus a square. This will be ln secant. Read it from here. It is x over a plus what is tan? It is opposite over adjacent. That is the root over a. Now this is the final answer, but we can simplify it a little bit. I mean, let us write it this way.
Here we just combine the two fractions since they have the same denominator a.
Now let us use the log properties to have the following. Ln x plus the root minus ln absolute value of a plus constancy. No need for absolute value because a is positive. Now look here. Ln a is a constant and c is a constant. So put everything here to be a new constant, call it c1 if you wish. So the final answer will be ln this plus constant c1. Alright, quick notes. If your work is correct, then you will break the root. And we said, if you input x equals secant, you will get a tan theta. This is not a magic. In fact, it comes from the identity. The identity is secant with the tan. So if you input secant, you will get tan. Or if you input tan, you will get secant. This is one thing. And if your work is correct, then this root is appearing in the triangle. Alright. Here I have also a final note. In the interval here, I didn't put the equality. Why? I did this in a purpose. Look here. The root is appearing in the denominator. And that root is equal a tan theta. But what is tan zero? Zero. So it is not allowed to put zero in the denominator. Similarly, tan pi is zero. So it is not allowed to put this in the denominator. So you need to exclude zero and pi. All right. Here we have a question. He said, from where we get ln a or ln absolute value of a? Recall this from math 002. If a is positive and b greater than 0, ln a over b is equal ln a minus ln b. So this is a property. Till now we solve examples for this and this and this. Now let us see a definite integral. The integral from minus 2 over 3 up to 0 dx over 9x squared plus 4 all to the power 3 over 2. First, note that this is a root. If you didn't see it, look here. What is something to the power 3 over 2? It is the root all to the power 3. Since the root is the power half, then you multiply by 3, you will get 3 over 2. Is it clear? So I already wrote it for you. Note that 9x squared plus 4 to the power 3 over 2, it is equal the root all to the power 3. What is inside the root? 9x squared can be written 3x all square. We need this. And this is 4, we write it as 2 to the power 2. So what is the suitable substitution? Clearly, we need to use the tangent substitution because you have addition between them. What is next? Here, we have root a square plus x square. So we put this x here. Look here carefully. And we put this a here. But here, instead of this x, we have 3x. So in the substitution, you can say 3x equal a, which is in this case 2, since we have addition, then I will use the tangent substitution. I will repeat this because this is very important. Instead of this x, we have 3x. So in the substitution, you need to write 3x instead of this x. This is 2, put it here. You have addition, you will use the tangent substitution where theta on this interval between minus pi over 2 to pi over 2. Okay, this is one thing. This is the fast method, by the way. If this is not clear to you or it is difficult, look here. You can use a substitution. U equal 2, 3x. If you do it this way, for sure you need to find du, etc. You will end up with u square plus 2 square. Then you are at this stage. Then your substitution would be u equal 2 tan theta. But what is my u? It is 3x. So we end up with 3x equal 2 tan theta, which is the same as this one. All right. Now let us find dx. If you differentiate both sides, you will say 3dx equal 2 secant square theta d theta. Now, since this integral is definite, then let us change the boundaries. Or you can find the indefinite integral, then you evaluate at the end. But it's better to change the boundaries. Now, when x equal to minus 2 over 3, which is the lower limit over here, then we need to substitute in this equation only. So if you plug this x over here, you will get minus 2, since this 3 will disappear with this 3. Then you will get minus 2 equal 2 tan theta. What is this equation? Simply, it is tan theta equal to minus 1. Now we need to solve this equation by taking inverse for both sides. What is theta here? It should be minus pi over 4. This is very important. Whatever you get here should be in this interval. Let me clarify this because usually the students miss this. If we say tan theta equal to minus 1, then this equation has infinitely many solutions. Yes, I really mean it. It has infinitely many solutions. For example, the first solution in the quadrant number 2, which is 3 pi over 4. Right? And we have another one here, which is minus pi over 4. So you can add 2k pi to get the infinitely many solutions. All right? But be careful. We need only the one that appearing on this interval. Simply, you can take inverse for both sides because we are in this interval. All right? Now let us plug 0 here to get 0 equal 2 tan theta. This is a very simple equation. Tan theta equal to 0, then theta should be 0 only. Again, let me remind you, tan theta equal to 0, it has infinitely many solutions. 0, pi, 2 pi, etc. Plus and minus. But we need the one that appearing here in this interval. So, do you see the beauty of this interval? Now, let us finish out this root. As we said, it is root to the power 3. Look here, I need 3x squared. Read it from here. Take power 2 for both sides to get 3x all square, which I need, equal 4 tan square theta plus 2 square, that is 4. Again, let me remind you, if your work is correct, then you will have 4, 4 here. I mean the same number so that you can take it outside the root. You will get 2, then you end up with 1 plus tan square. Still, we are under this power 3. Now let us simplify this a little bit to get 2. 1 plus tan square is secant square. Under the root, it will be secant. And since we are in this interval, no need for absolute value. So we get 2 secant theta. And we are again under the power 3. So we end up with 8 secant cubed theta. Now let us plug everything back. Remember, minus 2 over 3, it became minus pi over 4. This 0 became 0. Dx, read it maybe from here, it will be 2 over 3 secant square theta d theta. Be careful, need to divide by 3 to get dx. We have this thing to the power 3 over 2. We work it out and we get 8 secant cubed. If you simplify 2 over 3 over 8, believe me, you will get 2 over 24. Then you have minus pi over 4 up to 0. Simplify secant square with secant cubed. You will get secant in the denominator. In other words, 1 over secant is equal cosine theta d theta. If you simplify here, you will get 1 over 12. Integrate cosine, you will get sine theta evaluated from minus pi over 4 to 0. And if you plug 0, you will get 0. Minus. What is sine minus pi over 4? Yes, you are right. It is minus root 2 over 2. This is a computation. You can check this. It is equal root 2 over 24. Alright, any question? Question number 6. It says integrate x over root 3 minus 2x minus x squared. Here, I think you notice something. There is 2x over here. So what shall we do? It is not of this form. Yes, you are right. We need to complete squares to absorb this minus 2x. So let me do it carefully. First, let us take the coefficient of x squared outside. I mean, let us take minus from here and here. You will end up with x squared plus 2x. All right, until now? Now, please do not touch this 3. Leave it at the end. Now, we need to add and subtract. I mean, we need to complete the squares. So I will say x squared plus 2x. Then I need to add 1. From where I get this number 1? You divide this number by 2. You get 1. Square it. You will get 1. Now, this is our 3 back. This is not correct until now. You need to modify this change. See here, we add 1, but we have minus outside. So overall, it is like we are subtracting 1. So to fix this error, add 1. Double check your computation. You have minus x squared minus 2x. We have it here. Minus 1 plus 1. This will kill this part. And you have the 3 outside. Now just simplify this. 3 plus 1, isn't it 4? Minus, what is this? Isn't it x plus 1 all square? If you take root here, you will get x. Root the last one, you will get 1. And take the sine of the middle here over here. So our integral over here is nothing but x dx root this term. Or allow me to write it this way. 2 square minus x plus 1 all square. Now, what is the suitable substitution? You have two ideas. Either you say u equal x plus 1, then you say u equal 2 sine theta. This one thing. Or simply, this x became x plus 1. So in the substitution, I will say x plus 1 equal a sine theta. What is my a? Clearly, it is 2. Why did I say the sine substitution? Because you have difference. See it here. All right, where theta between minus pi over 2 up to pi over 2. X plus 1 equal to sine theta means that dx equal 2 cosine theta d theta. And let us work out the root. 2 square minus x plus 1 all square is equal 4 minus, what is x plus 1? Square. Read it from here. Just square both sides to get 4 sine square theta. And I said this many times. If you have 4, 4, then your work is correct. Take it outside the root to get 2. Then we end up with 1 minus sine square theta. This is cosine square. Under the root, it will be cosine only, no absolute value, because we are in this nice interval. So at the end of the day, we get 2 cosine theta. Our integral I is equal. Look here. What is your x? Maybe you can read it from here. Isn't it 2 sine theta minus 1? All divided by the root. Our root is 2 cosine theta. And what is the x? Read it from here. It is 2 cosine theta. It is very simple integral. Cancel 2 cosine with 2 cosine. Then you are end up with integral of 2 sine theta minus 1. Minus 2 cosine theta minus theta plus constant c. Now let us create our triangle over here. What is our sine theta? Read it from here. Sine theta will be x plus 1 all over 2. That means this will be x plus 1 and this will be 2. What do you think about this guy? It will be 2 square, which is 4, minus this guy, x plus 1 all square. All right. Now let us finish everything. What is cosine? Clearly, it is the root over the hypotenuse. Minus, what is my theta? Read it from here. This will be sine inverse of x plus 1 all over 2 plus constant c. So this is the final answer. You can cancel this 2 with this 2. As we said, if your work is correct, then you should get the root. Look here. This root is exactly this root. Isn't it this one? And look here. We input 2 sine, then the output will be 2 cosine theta. But be careful. You need to use the correct substitution. Usually the students miss this part. All right. Question 7. Find the integral of 1 over 3 plus 4x minus 4x squared all to the power 3 over 2. Here we need to complete squares since we have this term 4x over here. Now I will give you 1 minute to check that 3 plus 4x minus 4x squared equal to this 4 minus this bracket all square. All right, time is up. As we said in the previous exercise, we need to take the coefficient of x squared as a common factor from this term and this term. If we do so, we get minus 4, x squared minus x, and add this 3 at the end. Now we need to complete squares. What is the coefficient of x? It is minus 1. Divide by 2, you get minus half. Take a square, you will get 1 over 4. So I will add 1 over 4 here. And what shall I do here to fix this modification? Look here, I added 1 over 4, but I multiplied by minus 4. So overall, I subtracted 1. So I need to add 1. Now let us write this. This will be 4, and this will be minus 4x minus 1 over 2 all square. Why? Take the root of the first, take the root of the last, and take the sign of the middle tier. Now let us simplify this a little bit. Minus 2 square times x minus half all square plus 4. Put this 2 inside, you will get 2x minus 1 all square plus 4. All right, so this is what I wrote over here. Now, this integral will be root 2 square minus this bracket all square, which is the thing over here. And do not forget the power 3. We need to use the sine substitution. How? Because we get radical of this form, a square minus something square. So we need to say x equal a sine theta. But here I will say 2x minus 1. Why? Look here. X is replaced by 2x minus 1. So I will write it here. A sine theta, my A is 2. So this is 2 sine theta. Now let us find dx. This will be 2 dx equal 2 cosine theta d theta, and you can cancel this 2 with this 2. Now let us work out the root. This root is equal 4 minus this bracket square. Look here. If you take power 2 here, you will get 4 sine square. Take 4 outside the root to get 2 root 1 minus sine square theta, and we set this to be cosine theta. Now our integral I is equal dx. Read the dx from here, it is cosine. You can cancel 2 with 2. The root, see it here, we work it out and it was 2 cosine theta. But do not forget we have power 3. If you simplify this, you will get 8 down here. This will be cosine cubed and here cosine. So at the end we get 1 over cosine squared, that is secant square theta d theta. Now integrate this to get 1 over 8 tan theta plus constant c. Now let us recall our substitution. It was 2x minus 1 equal to sine theta, which is equivalent to sine theta equal 2x minus 1 over 2. So that means this will be 2x minus 1 and this will be 2. And this side will be 4 minus this one square under the root for sure. Now what is my tan? It will be this over this. So we will get 2x minus 1 over the root. And if you need to simplify, this root is equal to this thing, root of 3 plus 4x minus 4x squared. This is the final answer. Here we have final remarks. Remark number 1, you will understand it if we find the integral x dx over root x squared plus 4, which is given over here. This integral can be done using two methods. The first one is to take x equal to tan theta, where theta between minus pi over 2 up to pi over 2. Let us check this quickly. What is our x? This is 2 tan theta dx. Clearly this is 2 secant square theta d theta. And what is the root? I will leave it for you to check that it is 2 secant theta, because if you input tan, you get secant. Now simplify 2 with 2, secant with secant, to end up with integral 2 secant theta tan theta d theta. But what is this? This is 2 secant theta plus constant c. Now let us create our triangle over here. Clearly the substitution is x equal to tan theta, or equivalent tan theta equal x over 2. So this will be my x, this will be my 2, and this will be the square root of x square. So what is the secant? First let us find the cosine, which is 2 over the root. So the secant will be the root over 2. Alright, and if we simplify, we get root x square plus 4 plus constant c. This is one way, but there is an easier method. Think about it. Yes, you are right. We need to let u equal x squared plus 4, because the derivative is upstairs, right? So du will be 2x dx. And hence, this integral will be x dx. Read it from here. This is half du, and this is the root of u. You can write it as half integral u to the power minus half du, and this will be 1 over 2 u to the power half times 2 plus constant c. If you simplify things, you will get root u. And what is my u? It is x squared plus 4 plus constant c. So we get the same result. But what is my point here? My point here is that if you have an easy method, follow it. Don't go for advanced methods. Now let us see remark number 2. You can use trig substitution even if the root is missing. For example, what about this integral? 1 over x squared plus 1 all squared dx. Here we do not have a root, but you have something square plus x squared. Yes, you can use x equal to tan theta. We will do this example later on in section 7.4. x equal to tan theta, if you do it, you will get 1 plus tan square theta all square. What is dx? From here you can see that this is secant square theta d theta. Let us simplify this to get secant square over. This is secant square all square, that is secant to the power 4 theta d theta. And if you simplify this, you will get 1 over secant square, that is cosine square theta d theta. And please finish the solution. Also, what about this integral, 1 over x square plus 1 dx? This is tan inverse, right? Can we use trig substitution? Yes, let us try the same substitution. What is dx? It is secant square theta d theta. And put x equal to tan, you will get 1 plus tan square theta. But secant square equal 1 plus tan square. So this integral will be integral 1 d theta. And what is that? Theta plus constant c. Tell me your theta. You can read it from here to get tan inverse of x plus constant c. All right. Now let us see remark number 3. And this is for your information only. We will not ask you this in the exam. For the root x squared plus a square, you can use the substitution x equal a hyperbolic sine theta. And similarly, for the root x square minus a square, you can use x equal a hyperbolic cosine theta, where x is positive. Just to understand it, let us start with the first one, for example. Here, if we let x equal a sine theta, then this root will be root a square hyperbolic sine square theta, because you just take power 2 for both sides, plus a square, and this is equal a. If we take a to be positive, we get hyperbolic sine square plus 1, and what is that? That is hyperbolic cosine square. And what is this? This is a absolute value of cos theta, but the hyperbolic cosine is always positive, so we break the root easily. So do you see the beauty of this substitution? Again, let me remind you that these things will not come in the exam, but these for your information only. This is the end for section 7.3. Thank you very much.